Good morning, everybody. This is Sangeeta Saxena, Editor, Aviation and Defense Universe, getting you live from Aviation India 2024. We are here at JW Marriott in Aero City of New Delhi, and we have with us the Secretary General, MRO Association of India, and the Indian partner to the event, Mr. Pulak Sen. Good morning, Mr. Sen. Welcome to ADU's chat room. Good to have you here.
Good morning, Sangeeta ji. How are you today?
Absolutely fine. Looking forward to day two. Today is day two, Mr. Sen. And the show kicked off yesterday. How has it been for you?
It has been good. There have been good speakers who have come and given their word of caution and advice to the entire aviation community present here. And we hope that this show will bring some good effect to the Indian industry.
Yes, and we saw a big crowd yesterday and a lot of listeners to the event. So how do you think that, since it's organized by a British company, how much have they been able to get into the Indian-ness of the show?
It will take some time for them to get into the Indian-ness of the show. I am sure Mark Brown, who is the owner of this company, will definitely put his efforts to make it more indigenized, if I may use this word. Thank you.
And also, Mr. Sen, we discussed and brainstormed every aspect yesterday. Whatever is left, we'll do today. What are the pain areas, according to you, with the aviation industry at the moment?
The aviation industry at the moment is growing at its seams. You know, there are more than 2,000 aircraft to come into the fleet. Currently, on June 7th, I know there are 777 aircraft in the fleet of Indian carriers, and this is going to grow. In fact, around 10 to 15 aircraft per month is entering the Indian fleet, and it will pose a problem in all spheres of aviation operation, be it pilot, be it engineers, be it ground staff and airport staff. This is where we have to put up our might to get new people inducted into the Indian aviation industry.
And another very important factor that which we thought, you know, could be a very important reason for the industry not growing so strongly is that we still have all maximum leased aircraft. So how can we get the airlines to buy these aircraft?
Sangeeta ji, India, the Indian aviation community has lots of leased aircraft, and it has been a tradition over the past 10 years to have leased aircraft. Only Air India and IndiGo are the airlines who have been inducting some new fleet owned by them. Some of them are leased out also. This will take some time to change.
Okay. And what are the discussions you expect in today's session on the MRO industry of the aviation world?
As you know, the MRO industry is growing in India, and the industry has to scale up to meet the challenges that is being thrown by the airlines to the engineering fraternity. We have to organically grow and build up our MRO capabilities in India.
And in addition to that, we have a general aviation which is growing in India. I won't call it nascent, it's active. But how do you expect it to get its, fractional ownership model running, FBOs running? What do we expect to happen to that industry in our discussions today?
Sangeeta ji, fractional ownership has never been a forte in India, though it was started long ago by Taneja Aerospace with their P-68 aircraft. They had six aircraft which was given for fractional ownership, but the government did not play card, and it died its own death at that time. I don't think the government is still keen to allow people to have fractional ownership, which is the model everywhere else. And the business jet community is growing everywhere except for India, be it fixed wing or helicopters. Our fleet is diminishing. So this is where the government has to look into and play along with the community to strengthen our fleet and presence.
And we have a big city made by the private, under Prime Minister's special guidance, the GIFT City in India, which is housing a lot of leasing companies and finance companies. Is leasing and finance, leasing, yes, it is already there, but finance, is it going to be a very important factor?
It is going to be a very important factor, as you rightly said, but we want the Indian banks to participate in the GIFT City. They are not there at the moment, and we hope the Indian banks will come and take advantage of the leasing models that are there in India, which is really cheaper than the international leasing market.
Right, that's wonderful to hear that, Mr. Sain. Thank you very much for this interview. By the time we end with the show, I'm sure we'd have lots more to hear from you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.